tag team titles will also be up for grabs. The Acolytes will defend. We speculated all week long who Kane was going to choose as his tag team partner. It will be the Road Dogg.
Also tonight on Sunday Night Heat, The Undertaker, Mr. Ass, one-on-one.
Intercontinental Championship in the ring with challenger from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing at 244 pounds, Val Venis.
Val Venis with an opportunity to win the Intercontinental Championship tonight from the new title holder, D'Lo Brown.
Who knows what Val's going to say? We are live.
Hello, ladies. You know something, ladies? The Big Val Boski is a lot like a Republican tax cut. You know, the harder you work, the less I'll pull out, and the more I'll pump back into your economy.
Nobody does it quite like Val Venis.
Do what you're gonna do.
And it was last week on Raw and Four that D'Lo Brown took a giant step, a dual champion, after winning the Intercontinental Championship from Jeff Jarrett. I know you live by the sword, you die by the sword, and perhaps Jarrett's reliance on Denver's puppies came back to bite him. Or maybe the way Jeff Jarrett says, perhaps the puppies helped bite him. Either way, D'Lo Brown is both the Intercontinental and the European champion. That is some rarefied air for D'Lo.
D'Lo and Val, Intercontinental title on the line. What a way to kick off Sunday Night Heat, live from the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Well, wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
The bird's eye appears to be here at the commentator's position. Jeff Jarrett and Denver joining us.
What I want to talk about is it's been almost a week since I made my
call
to D'Lo Brown, and I've heard no response. But not only am I going to take my belt back, I'm going to take his coveted European title. And don't worry about the puppies. I've got them in my doghouse, and they're not coming out tonight.
Well, I know, Deborah, probably it's been a very trying week for you. Deborah, I'd like to ask you...
No, you don't talk to Deborah. I've told her. She's in her place. I set her straight. You know it, and I know it the whole world. She's the reason that I'm not the Intercontinental Champion. But I'm going to set things straight as soon as I get my opportunity. D'Lo has to make a response.
Well, D'Lo Brown working on all cylinders, hammering away on Val Venis. Jeff, you once called yourself the self-proclaimed greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time. However, D'Lo Brown, I guess, would be the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time right now. He's working on
Michael,
Val.
You can talk an awful lot, but you have to back it up the ring, and I can back it up.
Wait a minute, cover now. Here's Val 2. Oh, almost a 3 count, but a kick out by D'Lo. Val Venis now in control of D'Lo Brown. We're joined by Jeff Jarrett and Deborah at ringside. You asked for that rematch, Jeff.
I've heard no response, and there is absolutely there's no excuse for that.
Tremendous maneuver by Val, hook of the leg. There's
just
two
because Deborah was in the wrong place at the wrong time. I don't have my Intercontinental title belt around my waist. But that isn't my fault. It's Deborah's fault. Now, how come I have to suffer the consequences? I should have my title shot, and I'm going to get it one way or another.
But, Jeff, give me a break. You got to give D'Lo Brown some credit. I mean, he did take the Intercontinental Championship away from you on Raw.
Do I have to reiterate myself over and over and over? It was because of Deborah. She was in the wrong place at the wrong time. And nobody, I mean nobody, is going to get an opportunity to IC belt. And I'm going to see to it. One way or another, I'm going to get it. Val Venis will not come out of this match your champion.
Jeff,
I'll see to it.
You're making a lot of excuses. Wait a minute. Well, Jeff Jarrett set it up. And Jeff Jarrett now in the ring. And he blindsides Val Venis, making sure that Val does not take the Intercontinental title away from D'Lo Brown.
While certainly nothing was decided between Val and D'Lo. Intercontinental champion of all time have it.
And Jeff Jarrett stepped in it, folks. Val Venis and D'Lo Brown doing a number on Jeff Jarrett. And Jarrett heading for higher ground with Deborah.
Jeff Jarrett blamed everybody but himself.
ankle.
And now Timo Brown and Val Venis in each other's faces. Jeff Jarrett and Deborah continue to argue.
Boy, what a night. You can just feel the energy here inside the Joe Louis Arena, Michael, and we've only started. We've only just begun here on Sunday Night Heat.
Sunday Night Heat coming to you live from Detroit, folks. Tag team titles will be on the line tonight. And as we told you, we just found out before we went on the air, Kane has chosen the Road Dog to be a tag team partner. When they take on the Acolytes tonight, the tag team titles are on the line.
Plus, you will also see the Lord of Darkness, The Undertaker, one-on-one against Mr. Ass. And you have to wonder if The Rock's opponent for SummerSlam and Mr. Ass will find out what Armageddon is all about.
Yeah, and you know the Big Show will probably be lurking in the shadows if The Undertaker is down here in that big matchup. Wait a minute. And there's the Road Dog and the Big Red Machine, Kane. They will take on the Acolytes for the tag team titles tonight. Is the Joe Louis Arena going to turn into the Dog Pound?
What does everybody want?
We are back live on Sunday Night Heat.
What does everybody need?
Ladies and gentlemen, the former WWF Hardcore Champion, Al Snow.
Folks, I can tell you this, Al Snow's gone completely off the deep end ever since Head had a spike driven through his head. Al Snow is now driven by a dog who apparently talks to him. The dog is named Pepper.
Well, Al, I know it's been a trying couple of weeks for you.
Oh, yeah.
The voices in the head, the screaming has stopped, and all appears to be well. Medication probably finally kicking in, and you got a new little
medicine now. Pepper has been such a godsend to me, haven't you? You've been the light, the way. You've shown me the true nature of what I am, haven't you, Pepper?
You honestly expect everybody here to believe that that dog talks to you?
You don't believe? You don't believe that Pepper talks to me? What about Timmy and Lassie? What about Dorothy and Toto? George Jetson and Astro? Shaggy and Scooby? You mean that Mr. Ed was on mute when the camera stopped rolling?
Al, that was TV, movies, cartoons. This is reality.
My reality is, Kevin Kelly, my reality is I'm the Crown Prince of Hardcore, and I don't have a hardcore belt anymore. So, Bossman, I know you can hear me. Bossman at SummerSlam, I want... No, I'm sorry. Pepper and I, we want our hardcore title match, and we want our belt back. And at SummerSlam, we're damn well going to get it.
Al Snow is... Wait a minute. Here comes Big Boss Man, and we may get an answer now. Boss Man defeated Al Snow and fully loaded for the Hardcore Championship. In fact, it was in that match that Al Snow was begging the Boss Man to put him out of his misery. He was suffering pain after that spike was driven through Head's head. But apparently Al Snow has come to some sort of accompaniment, companionship now with Pepper.
You know I beat you before.
It's Brad at the Joe getting all over the Boss Man.
You know I beat you before, and I'll be damn glad to do it again. And you know why? Do you want to know why?
Yeah, I want to know.
See, when I get through with you, I'm going to have a little fun with that rat you call a dog.
Uh-oh.
See, I've been wondering how many times I had to smash that dog before he'd start talking to me. I've been wondering, maybe I ought to take this nightstick, shove it up that little dog's butt, dip him in some batter, deep fry him, and make a real corn dog out of him. Or maybe, Al, I'll take the simple route and just put my foot on his head and slowly but surely pop it like a bug. But either way, punk, this is fact, not fiction. At SummerSlam, I'm going to get you and your little dog, too.
Well, the Hardcore Champion with absolutely no respect for Al Snow is Pepper. And Al Snow's on at SummerSlam 2 weeks from tonight. Bossman, Al Snow for the Hardcore title. And I'll tell you, that gentleman right there, Al Snow, is completely whacked. And there you see the Acolytes, Faarooq and Bradshaw, who later on tonight, live on Heat, we'll take on Kane and Road Dogg. Tag team titles on the line.
Wow, that body painting, a unique and artistic look. And Tori, we understand, will face Ivory for the WWF Women's
Slam. And tonight here live on E, Tori in action.
Scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring, Tori. And her opponent from Burlington, North Carolina, Lexie Fyfe.
Sunday night, he's live from Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. And tonight, he brought to you by Snickers. Not going anywhere for a while? Grab a Snickers. Hungry? Why wait?
And by WWF The Music Volume 3. Hear the original entrance theme songs of your favorite WWF superstars. Available at music stores everywhere.
And by Castrol, the official motor oil of the WWF. Now when you buy a case of Castrol DPX motor oil, get one of these 6-foot WWF superstar posters free. See case for details.
There's always been an air of mystery surrounding Tori. A lot of questions. And, well, the women of the WWF, Michael, certainly are a dynamic and multi-talented. They really are the cream of the crop.
And here's Tori now, going to work on Lexie Fyfe.
That name's a tongue twister,
huh? It is. Lexie into the corner now, and Tori in a little bit of trouble as we start.
Looks like she's going to be looking to pose some problems here for Tori, who, as we said, will go to SummerSlam to take on Ivory for that women's title.
SummerSlam 2 weeks from tonight, of course, the main event, Stone Cold Triple H, the WWF Championship, the special guest referee. Oh, my. Jesse the Body Ventura, who we understand will be appearing on Raw tomorrow night.
What a night tomorrow promises to be. We'll be in Chicago at the Allstate Arena.
Oh, my. What a drop kick by Tori. Folks, just a reminder, here's the cover now. Hook of the leg by Tori. Shoulder up by Lexie Fyfe. Just a reminder, immediately following Heat tonight, it's G versus E.
We understand Mankind is going to be doing a future episode of G versus E. It's a critically acclaimed new show, and it's on right after Sunday Night Heat here on USA.
Lexie Fyfe giving Tori all she can handle here. Still to come tonight on Heat, the Acolytes defending the tag team titles against Kane and the Road Dogg. And what about the Undertaker and Mr. Ass?
Certainly.
Oh, wow. Nice spear by Tori. It goes to work with the right hand now.
Boy,
Lexie Fyfe
pounding away on her now. Well, the Undertaker, Mr. Ass, it certainly is going to be a very entertaining night. Who knows what's going to, we're going to have in store.
Oh, great maneuver. Hook of the leg by Tori. There's two. Folks, this one's over. As quick as that, Tori picks up the win over Lexie Fyfe.
Tori.
But the question is, can she do it to Ivory at SummerSlam in 2 weeks?
Wait a minute. Look up the aisle.
Well, speaking of Ivory, here comes the women's champion. Tori doesn't see her. And Ivory with a championship to the back of the head and out of the small, the back. And Ivory brutally attacking Tori.
This Ivory has shown a real sadistic streak as of late.
Wait a minute.
What is she doing?
Ivory just screamed, "You want body paint?"
Oh, yeah.
Come on now.
Oh, this is awful.
Oh, please.
This is absolutely awful.
Well, folks, we talked earlier on, Tori likes body paint, and Ivory's using her as a canvas here.
This is degradation, though, Michael.
Tell these people what you really are.
Come on now.
Well, you'd think the WWF Women's Champion would conduct herself a little more class than that.
Well, speaking of champions, Kane and the Road Dogg with an opportunity tonight on Heat to become tag team champions. Can they coexist when they meet the Acolytes tonight?
Double G always kicks that shears knit doggy style. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, D-Generation X, proudly brings to you. I'm T to the R to the U to the E. I'm that D, that O to that double G. The Road Dog, Jesse James. Now then, this matchup is very important to me. You see, if I win, that means I'm once again the WWF Heavyweight Tag Team Champion of the World! Hey, I was a member of a little team called the New Age Outlaws. Well, things have changed. You see, if you know who I know and you know what I mean, by my side is that big red machine!
Wait a minute, Faarooq and Bradshaw. Two against the Road Dog, and they're not waiting for this thing to start. The tag team champions hammering away at the Dog. Well, they put it through. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, my. Big complete. Wait. And folks, we've said it before, but Kane has a lot riding on this one. He's battling for his fallen friend. And Michael, it seems as we get more into Kane's emotional growth, it seems that he gets physically stronger as well. Kane has never been better. But how is one man, even the Big Red Machine, going to be able to stand up to both Acolytes?
Well, the Road Dog's going to get back into this thing. I can feel it, folks. The Acolytes are taking him out. Road Dog's lying on the mat right out here in front of us. And it's a two-on-one. One-on-one, Bradshaw and the Big Red Machine, Kane.
Michael, I'm not so sure if a Road Dog's going to be able to get back into this one.
Look at this now, Kane, sidewalk slam, Bradshaw in trouble. Tag team titles are on the line.
Well, Kane's now been able to isolate on Bradshaw, but now he's going back out after Faarooq. The emotions that are churning within Kane have got to be very strong and somewhat distracting as well.
Road Dog in a serious way outside the ring, and look at Kane now. Bradshaw in trouble, and the big seven-footer going to climb the rope.
Boy, this is amazing every time I see it. Take a look up the ramp.
Oh, my! And wait a minute. The big shot. Hardcore Holly, who's had some problems with the Acolytes in the past.
And he's had his problems with Kane as well.
The big shot, Hardcore Holly. And wait a minute. He's lined up in Kane's corner now.
Apparently he wants to be Kane's partner. Maybe he and Kane have patched up their differences, Michael.
Well, we did mention major differences between Hardcore Holly and the Acolytes. Hardcore Holly now tags himself in.
Oh, come on!
What is this? Holly taking advantage of a fallen Kane! And wait a minute! And the Acolytes now double-teaming Kane! And now Holly's nuts!
What's he trying to prove?
He's borderline psycho! And now Holly's attacking the Acolytes!
He's just going after anybody that moves!
First, Holly lined up in Kane's corner. Then he backstabbed Kane, and then he went after the Acolytes!
After helping the Acolytes!
Oh.
Whose side is he on? I think he's on the side of insanity. Holly actually believes he is a super heavyweight. We're finally beginning to see some motion from the Road Dog, slowly being able to barely climb up the apron.
But the Acolytes have done a number on the big shot Hardcore Holly, on the Big Red Machine Kane, and also on the Road Dog. Faarooq and Bradshaw, who have been in a mean way since the situation with the Undertaker and Big Show
last week.
And look at the Acolytes now, hammering away on Kane. And there's Big Show and Undertaker.
Josie and Holly down.
And Undertaker. Big Show looked like he wanted to head out to the ring, and Undertaker wouldn't allow it.
Michael, did the Undertaker just prevent the Big Show from helping the Big Shot?
Wait a minute. The Venis here. He's not scheduled to be here. The People's Champ is live on Heat.
WWF referees are trained to be impartial, maintain composure, and by all means, stay out of harm's way. Yeah, right.
I have the power.
Jesse the Body Ventura returns to the ring for an out-of-body experience.
It's the body rules. It's my rules or the highway.
WWF SummerSlam, presented live by Chef Boyardee. Sunday, August 22nd on pay-per-view.
The world will get shot.
Terri, I can't keep up with you anymore. You're wearing me out. Please, can you have a little bit of mercy on me? Please.
Oh, me, baby. I seem to be able to get your ire up, but not much else. Why don't you come in here to me, baby? Yes, come here, my little pork chop. You drink up. Drink. There you go. You've got a match, so you need to hurry up. No, baby.
You gotta be kidding me.
No. You need all this. You need all the strength you can get. There you go. Good job.
Today. You see, because I've already kicked your ass enough. See, what I want is that Pillsbury Doe-looking snowman, or whatever he calls himself, that jumped my ass last time. Oh, you...
Wait a minute, here he is.
Wait a minute.
And here's the guy who jumped the Godfather a couple of weeks ago. And it's Droz, Prince Albert, and this strange guy in white hammering away in the Godfather.
And despite Prince Albert and Droz's claims to the contrary, I'd say it's pretty obvious. This mysterious man in white is definitely a part of their attack. And wait a minute, here comes a little bit of help. Val Venis hammering away on Prince Albert. Oh, wait a minute, that's not it, Michael. Here comes Chaz. Chaz into the ring.
He wants a piece of this guy in white as well.
What is the white guy's story here? What's his story?
Why, this is a street fight that is broken out.
Val Venis, Godfather, Chaz, hammering away.
I don't know if there's enough referees and WWF officials to separate these six men.
Okay, Pepper, it's real simple. I'm the Crown Prince of Hardcore. You're the Hardcore Dog. This is Hardcore Rules. Now, are you ready? Try and jump. One, two, three, jump. Jump. What? You're right. Damn, I forgot. I need to go get the table. That way you can go through one. I'll be right back. Just don't move.
We've witnessed the end of an era. We've seen the most defiant champion of all time. Now, expect the unexpected as we enter the dawn of a new age.
And folks, it don't get no bigger than this.
The WWF explodes onto network television when SmackDown premieres August 26th. Prepare for impact when the most dangerous soap opera invades prime time.
That countdown ends tomorrow night, but my question is, what's it counting down to?
Well, we are live tonight at the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit, the home of the NHL's Detroit Red Wings. And tonight, the home of live Sunday Night Heat. Both Chef Boyardee presents 1999 SummerSlam. Be the D. SummerSlam is just 2 weeks from tonight, from the sold-out Target Center in Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Terri. What have you done to me? I can't go out there like this. This is ridiculous.
You can go out there like that.
Oh, like that's going to help the situation.
I want you to meet somebody. Somebody very important. Say hello to Pepper.
Pepper?
Yeah.
Nice gerbil. All this time I thought you were growing a tail.
That's not funny.
Maybe later on the meeting can put a little Pepper on his taco. Look at its eyes.
Excuse me. Hold on a second. Can you take that for me? Can I have a drink of that?
Sure. Oh!
Al Snow hammering around the meanie! Taking exception with the meanie was just joking around with Pepper.
Well, meanie and Al Snow are almost like best friends.
Knock it off!
Come on now! Remind me not to joke about Pepper. This dog, Pepper, has driven Al Snow way, way off the dock.
Little dog's got some vicious little thoughts.
Well, that little dog is going to be in Al Snow's corner at SummerSlam. Hardcore title up for grabs against the Big Boss Man.
The contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, being accompanied by Terri Runnels. He weighs in at 250 pounds. Meat!
So Terri Runnels leading Meat to the ring. No jackal in here this evening. But Terri Runnels seems to have things well in hand. I don't know if she has the best interest of Meat's career in mind. She's been wearing him out, Michael. It's no secret about what's been going on behind the scenes. It'll be very humiliating to her in her efforts to really degrade this piece of Meat. That's really what he is to her.
Well, Terri Runnels has been humiliating Meat. She's been overheard saying in the locker room that she has been satisfied with Meat's performance, so to speak. Meat's been awfully tired as of late.
Tired in many matches, too.
Yeah, keeping late hours and not exactly being physically or mentally prepared when he gets to the squared circle. But I don't think Terri has concerns about his win-loss record.
I'll tell you what, he better be mentally prepared for this one. He's taking on the Hardcore Champ, Bossman.
From Collin County, Georgia, weighing in at 312 pounds, the World Wrestling Federation Hardcore Champion, the Big Bossman.
Non-title match here tonight on Heat. Comments the Big Boss Man made before, the disgusting things he wants to do to Pepper. I mean, it's horrific.
Well, he accepted Al Snow's challenge to defend the Hardcore Championship at SummerSlam. And folks, this information just in, speaking of title matches at SummerSlam, we understand it's just been signed. Jeff Jarrett and D'Lo Brown will meet at SummerSlam with both the Intercontinental title and the European title on the line.
It's going to be a history-making night. And of course, we know that Stone Cold Steve Austin will defend the WWF Championship against Triple H with Jesse the Body Ventura as the special guest referee.
So it's Big Boss Man now set to go to work on Meat. Sunday Night Heat, folks, has been cooking on all cylinders tonight, and it's about to get a bit hotter because still to come, The Undertaker will take on Mr. Ass.
Well, of course, the Rock will be taking on Mr. Astro at SummerSlam, Michael.
And Bossman now from behind on Meat.
Bossman a little hesitant to go after Meat there for a few seconds.
He seems very distracted here on Heat.
Well, he never can get his focus. He can never get mentally or physically prepared for contest. Seems as if Terry's always giving him last-minute notice.
Last-minute notice. Terry's been humiliating for weeks now. Well, how much more can this poor guy take? And look at Bossman with a right hand.
Well, let's face it, Michael. Meat is not the brightest color of Crayola in the box.
Big Boss Man Meat right here live on Sunday Night Heat. Boss Man's really taking it to Meat. And Meat now with a counter. Hammering away on his right hand, fighting with everything he has here. Boss Man whipped off the ropes. Great elbow by Meat,
who is a very physically gifted athlete. But with Terri Runnels in his life, I mean, really, she is just consumed with tearing him down. That's her way. That's Terri Runnels' way of getting back at the humiliating way she was treated by men.
Well, you know, I'll tell you what. I mean, it's embarrassing for everybody. I mean, we were back in the locker room earlier today. You could hear Terri Runnels just berating Meat in front of everybody that walked by. Other superstars, ring crew. I mean, it was
last week right here on Heat. She had him kiss his feet after he lost the match.
And Bossman now, oh my, to the back of Meat. I'll tell you, how much more can this Meat take? Terri Runnels strutting around at ringside, looking on.
Later on tonight, of course, The Undertaker one-on-one against Mr. Ass. What a battle that's going to be. And we saw The Rock combing the halls before. Completely unexpected, Michael, that the People's Champ would be here in attendance tonight in Detroit.
You know, we talked earlier on that Jacqueline has not accompanied her PMS mate Terri Runnels out to the ring. We've seen that in recent weeks. Perhaps Jacqueline not pleased with the way Terri Runnels is conducting this situation.
I think she's flat out frustrated with the way Terri has been carrying on with Meat behind the scenes. Jacqueline's all about business, and business hasn't been so good lately.
Bossman with a few choice words for Terri Runnels. Shot to the kidneys that time. Tell you, Meat has just not been focused as of late. Hard time concentrating in matches. Meat whipped across the ring now. Bossman pretty much had his way, but a great maneuver. Counter that time by Meat. And look out now. Oh! Low blow that time by Bossman. Meat whipped off the rope. And look at this.
Oh, wow.
Meat went for the high-risk maneuver, and Bossman countered.
Ow.
And this one's over. Bossman makes short work of Meat.
Here is your winner, the Big Bossman.
Ow. You know, Meat wasn't even ready to compete here tonight until you saw Terri Runnels giving him some sort of invigorating drink.
What is he dropping that?
Well, either way, the Boss Man could care less about Meat's problems. How sadistic the hardcore champion is pounding away. The Boss Man using that nightstick, and now Terri Runnels picks up the pieces of Meat. The Boss Man picks up the win. This situation here, very disturbing. Well, folks, tonight, right after G versus E on USA, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels on Pac Blue, the second of a two-part episode in all-new Pac Blue tonight, right after G versus E on USA.
Yeah, it's been a real tough assignment, we understand, for the commissioner in Hawaii, of all places. You've been able to see that.
Wait a minute. Well, The Rock's in the house. What the hell is The Rock up to? The People's Champ on his way out here live on Heat.
He was the most outrageous superstar of his generation.
Mr. Money, Mr. Charisma, Mr. Show Business.
The most outspoken broadcaster of his time.
You're nothing without Jesse the Body Ventura.
Now, the body is back. Jesse the Body Ventura, live tomorrow night on Raw.
Do you smell what The Rock is cooking?
The announce position? Oh, please.
I don't think we're going to get a word in edgewise.
technically the people's champ, is going to be joining us for commentary here tonight on WWE Heat.
I'm going to try to make nice with him.
Of course you will.
I don't want to get him upset.
And The Rock now joining us here.
Shut your mouth. The Rock needs no introduction anywhere. Do you feel the electricity? You probably feel a lot of things. You guys are the biggest freaks in the industry.
We certainly can smell it, as everybody can here tonight. And here comes your buddy, Rock.
Yeah, here's the Rock's buddy. Look at badass Billy Gunn.
The man the Rock will meet in SummerSlam, Mr. Ass. And Rock, you got to have revenge on it on your mind, because you were the front of a big joke by Mr. Ass this week. The people's ass was put up on the titantron.
Yeah, real big joke. The only joke is you out here yakking at The Rock. The Rock says, look at Billy Gunn, The Rock's opponent. Billy Gunn looks like a fine, expensive bottle of Dom Perignon. But in actuality, his talent is more like a cheap six-pack of brew.
If you had to evaluate Mr. Ass, what would you say Mr. Ass's greatest asset is?
Well, frankly, The Rock says Mr. Ass pretty much sucks.
Oh, folks, fasten your seatbelts. This is going to be a good one. Mr. Ass to take on The Undertaker.
Wow.
They said last week on Heat that Armageddon is upon us. This new union formed between The Undertaker and The Big Show. Rock, what do you think of this unholy alliance?
Shut up, Michael Cole. Like, you're impressed. You're easily impressed. I guess it's just a good game of pocketball impresses you. The Rock says, I tell you what, you really want to be impressed. Have The Undertaker pull his little black panties down, and he's got a new tattoo right by his rectum. It's got The Rock's foot is here.
And here we go now. Mr. Ass taking it right to The Undertaker, hammering away now. Rock and Roy, Mr. Ass, who cost you the chance to be the number one contender and to be the main event at SummerSlam. Oh!
Hello? Boy, the Mr. Ass certainly looks great. Very aggressive against The Undertaker.
What an elbow by The Undertaker that time. Going to work now on Mr. Ass. Wow!
The Rock can't take his eyes off him. Mr. Ass like laser beams.
You know what? Shut your mouth. Similar like you can't take your hands off The Rock's legs.
Shut your mouth.
The Rock can do his own talking. You act like all three of these jabronis, including that jabroni Chyna, impresses you.
Well, she is an impressive athlete, as is all.
Sure, she's impressive to you. You're easy to impress. You're dealing with The Rock, the people's champ out here.
What a boot by The Undertaker to Mr. Ass. Goes for the quick cover here. There's two. Mr. Ass gets the shoulder up.
People in Detroit, they're smelling it.
You're damn right they smell it. Listen to The Rock's fans. There's millions and millions at home chanting his name.
Mr. Ass now off the ropes. Baseball slide underneath the big leg. There's a drop kick trying to take the phenom off his feet. Look out now. Oh, what a counter by Mr. Ass.
Rock, what's the atmosphere going to be like at SummerSlam?
Here's a cover now. Two, Undertaker up.
It's quite simple. The Rock is going to go into his home away from home, Minneapolis, Minnesota. He's going to lay the smackdown on Billy Gunn's chin. Listen to The Rock's fans chanting his name.
Yeah, music to your ears.
Shut your mouth. You're a complete idiot, Michael Cole. The Rock says at SummerSlam, you're going to see three things. And, of course, that's a rock bottom, the people's elbow, and a smell what The Rock is cooking.
Mr. Ass,
say something.
Right to the eyes. There's a big right hand to the phenom.
Don't sit out here and kayfabe like an idiot.
Come on, Rock. What? Kayfabe?
Oh, shut your mouth.
Look at this now. Undertaker. Mr. Ass maybe going for the right here. There's the right hand by the phenom. This new alliance formed between The Undertaker and The Big Show. They promised Armageddon was upon us. The Undertaker said to be afraid. Be very afraid. Here's Mr. Ass now, whipped across the ring. The phenom, oh, what a counter by Mr. Ass. Foot to the face that time. Undertaker off the rope. Oh,
good, good for him. About the only good thing The Undertaker's ever done. The Rock says he hopes he broke your neck.
And The Undertaker now smells blood. He senses a fallen Billy Gunn here.
Rock, I know it's got to be bothering you that you're not going to be the one taking on Stone Cold Steve Austin at SummerSlam for the World Wrestling Federation
Championship. Stone Cold The Rock, it doesn't get any better than that. The Rock's day will come, and he'll be the best damn WWF champ there ever won. I'll tell you what, The Undertaker goes in the ring and leaves this jabroni out here. The Rock is going to give you a little bit of an example of what's going to happen at SummerSlam.
Undertaker elbow now to the face of Mr. Ass again, and the Phenom in total control.
Yeah, speaking of it, control, watch this.
Wait a minute, a rock. A rock now, going after Mr. Ass. Hammered away now. Look out, here comes the Big Show, and the Rock and Big Show, straight out in front of us. Paul Bearer going for a rock. Oh, clothesline by the Show. Big Show just drilled Rock right out in front of us. And in the ring, Michael, the Undertaker, Mr. Ass up high. Mr. Ass, tombstone time. Good night. Here's the cover. Folks, this one's over. Undertaker picks up the victory. But now right out in front of us, Big Show and Rock going at it. And the Undertaker hammered away on the People's Champion. A double team on the Rock. Big Show and Undertaker. Good.